Hey, it's Leif from Macworld, and today we're going to check out 10 of the best shortcuts for iPhone. It's an Apple app that simplifies complex tasks on your iPhone into a single action that could otherwise require a massive number of steps. Apple already has a handful of decent shortcuts in the in-app gallery, but regular iPhone users have made some of the best ones, and you'll find them hiding deep in third-party pages like the Shortcuts subreddit, Routine Hub, and Shortcuts Gallery. So I've pulled together a list of the shortcuts that best enhance the experience of iOS for all of us. They're super easy to install if you already have the Shortcuts app and the link, and we've listed the links for all the shortcuts right here in the video's description. You'll need to activate most of them through the Shortcuts app at first, but you can also tie them to specific icons on your home screen or trigger them with specific Siri commands. If you've never switched from Spotify to Apple Music solely because of the hassle of importing playlists, you want to check out the Playlist Converter shortcut from Redditor Lalos8. It's functional but limited, as it only takes the first 30 songs from a Spotify playlist and repackages them for Apple Music. To use it, simply copy the link for the playlist from the Spotify app share menu. You'll then click share again to access shortcuts, and from there you'll paste the URL into the Playlist Converter prompt. After you give Shortcuts permission to access Apple Music and give the new playlist a name, the shortcut works its magic. Keep in mind, though, that it will take a few seconds since it's sifting through iTunes for matches. This method works especially well if you're looking for a simple, free import option when someone shares a Spotify playlist. If you have far more than 30 songs to import, though, you'll want to check out a specialized app like SongShift. The simple item lookup shortcut from Redditor Jared Butters uses your iPhone's camera to scan the barcode of any item, which then allows you to check its listings on the websites of Amazon, Walmart, or Target. It works beautifully, but unfortunately this shortcut doesn't allow you to compare the prices at all three sites at once. Every time you use it, it'll only open the websites of Amazon, Walmart, and Target individually in a new window. But it's quite handy if you're just trying to figure out how prices compare among the heavyweights of online retail. Now, Apple already has a low power mode baked into iOS that turns off background refreshes and other features, but if you really want to squeeze every bit of life out of your battery, you'll want the Keep Me Alive shortcut from Shortcuts Gallery. It too turns on low power mode, but it also activates airplane mode and kills Wi-Fi and cellular connections while turning the brightness to zero and switching off your phone's sound. It can't turn off True Tone and Night Shift, but it gives you a little prompt explaining how to turn these off as well. There's just a small catch. You have to turn everything back on yourself. Fortunately, that's really just a matter of going into Control Center and turning off settings like airplane mode and low power mode. So it's easy enough to turn on the iPhone's Do Not Disturb mode through Control Center, but I've missed important text or calls because I've forgotten to switch it off when leaving a movie theater. The handy Do Not Disturb timer ensures that never happens again. Simply activate the shortcut through the Shortcuts app, and you'll see a prompt that asks if you want to set it for a number of minutes or a number of hours. Enter the desired number, click Done, and it's as simple as that. If you have to turn it off before the time is up, you can simply turn it off through your iPhone's lock screen. So few shortcuts have earned more attention than Redditor Robert Peterson's police shortcut, which triggers a complex sequence of events when you say, "Hey Siri, I'm getting pulled over." You can customize this controversial shortcut, but when fully activated, it pauses your music, it activates your front-facing camera, it starts recording video, it turns down your iPhone's brightness, it activates Do Not Disturb, and it sends a video of the encounter to a pre-programmed contact. So it's usually fairly difficult to download video and photos from the big social media sites, but the handy social media downloader from Wirexia 9 makes it easy to get around those roadblocks. Activate the shortcut through Safari's share button when you're visiting a page on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Dailymotion, or Instagram, and it will save the file to your Photos app. I've seen many shortcuts that do this for individual sites, but this one stands out for offering such a wide range of options. Even better, you can choose the quality of the videos before you download them, or you can simply download them as audio files. So sometimes it feels as though the internet runs on GIF files, but it's still surprisingly hard to make them. But that's no longer the case with the Convert Video to GIF shortcut, which allows you to make a GIF with any video in your phone's library. Once you activate it, the shortcut takes you to your phone's video collection where you can select which video you want to use. After choosing, the shortcut pulls up the video along with a slider that lets you crop the footage to the desired frames. Once you've done that, hit save, and it'll give you a preview of the GIF. After that, though, be sure to save the GIF through the Options button in the upper right. This is a crucial step. I tried uploading a GIF straight to Twitter, and it didn't work. Every website now has a dark mode, thanks to the dark mode shortcut from Redditor NDH4K4. To use it, click Share when you're visiting a website in Safari, and then select Dark Mode version 2 through the shortcut icon. Once you click Allow on a prompt that allows a little bit of JavaScript to run, you'll immediately see the site with a black background and white text. So keep in mind that it's best used for merely reading content, as it also inverts the colors in the images. An earlier version of the shortcut kept the images in their original format, but the text wasn't always visible. On the literal bright side, you simply need to refresh the page if you want to see an image properly. So I've placed a lot of emphasis on user-made shortcuts for this video, but there are plenty of decent shortcuts in Apple's in-app gallery. My favorite? It's easily the Remind Me at Work shortcut. The Reminders app already allows you to trigger a reminder at a specific spot, but there's kind of a long process involved if you want to do it manually. Instead, you only need to enter your address for home or work once when you set up the shortcut. After that, any reminder you make with the shortcut will trigger at that program location. And keep in mind that it doesn't have to be just home or work. If I'm being honest, I mainly use it for my local grocery store, as I'll get notifications from my grocery list the second I walk in the door. And that is it for now. We'll be on the lookout for more great shortcuts here at Macworld, and we'd love to hear about shortcuts that you found particularly useful as well. We'll see you around.